Sam, so today you're going to chat to us on video and video marketing. So if you would, just for everyone listening, just tell us a bit about yourself and what you do.
Yeah, so my name is Sam Lister. I'm currently 20 years old. Started my own digital marketing agency right after high school, so about 2 or 2.5 years ago. So I've always been entrepreneurial growing up. I'm just mowing lawns, doing anything I could to make money in creative ways. I've just really loved I've loved making money, but I've just loved the process of it. I've loved, again, like I said, finding unique ways on doing what I love to do, but also getting paid to do that. So that's a recurring theme really throughout my whole life. So it started off as being like a pizza cook, which I weirdly love to do. Then I manage a snow park and I'm a big snowboarder, and manage a baseball field and I'm a big baseball player. So everything is just centered around like my passion and what I've loved. So I decided not to go to college, higher university, towards the end of my high school career, just because I knew I could make more connections, better connections, make more money, all of those things faster if I didn't go to university, and university would just slow me down. So I just got to testing a bunch of different ventures in real estate, in e-commerce, in drop shipping, in Forex trading, cryptocurrency, literally anything I could do to make money. I was failing miserably at all of that because I was trying 100 different things at once. And any entrepreneurs know, like, it's you definitely get like shiny object syndrome of you want to test everything. So that's what I was doing. But I was documenting my story through video. I'm just making daily videos, telling the world what I was trying to do and what I was trying to build. And that just slowly started to get more and more momentum. And then I hopped over to LinkedIn in August of 2018. And within the first week, I had people reaching out asking if I could do videos for them and film videos for them. I just said yes to all of those opportunities. So I pretty much dropped everything else and just focused on video. So when I focused on one thing, essentially, then things started to move. So I launched my company shortly after. And then ever since then, I've just been pivoting and kind of just testing out different iterations of a marketing company, but all centered around video.
Very cool. And was video something you had a passion for, or was it just you kind of fell into it? It was like this opportunity just appeared.
Yeah, it's a great question. I definitely just like tripped and fell into it. I never took a photo class or a video class. I never actually touched a camera until after starting essentially a video production company, which I would turn into. But yeah, I was just filming everything with my iPhone. I hated video at first. It was definitely not a passion. So it's a unique story because it didn't start off as my passion like everything else, but then throughout a couple of years of doing it, I now realize the impact. Now I'm in love with it. So now it's one of my biggest passions, but at the start, it definitely, I hated it. I did not like video at
all. Video editing is a learning curve, all right?
Yeah, video editing, but even like being in front of the camera and just talking to the camera, I was so awkward. I was so cringy. I love like public speaking, so I'm like, oh, video will be so easy. But when I faced the camera for the first time with my selfie iPhone, I froze, and it was super hard, super awkward, super challenging for me. But I just pushed through it and just created day after day. So now we're here. 2 years later.
Excellent. So when you're out there talking to businesses, obviously documenting your entire process must have been an interesting journey, but how do you sell video to maybe companies who aren't using it at the moment? What's kind of your pitch?
Are they willing to use it? Like, are they interested in it, or is it just like flat out cold? Like, hey, we're not doing video. We don't really want to do video. How would I convince them to?
Let's go with both.
Okay, for the convincing side, I drop the conversation right away and don't convince anyone to use it. I spend zero time trying to convince anyone to use my services. I don't know if that's typical or not, but if someone doesn't want to, I don't push saying, hey, this is why you need to. It's like, okay, if you don't want to, come to me when you want to. There's enough fish out there to catch. Typically, the people I reach out to are already doing video, whether it's personal brands or bigger like Fortune 500 corporations. They're already doing video and they already know the importance of that. So that's the only people I target, because it just saves time on both ends if I don't need to pitch them the actual video content. Hey, here's why video is important. Yes, I'm leaving money on the table, but I'm a small fish, so I can't handle everything. So that's where I choose to spend most of my time on really just forming those relationships with people already creating or brands already creating, and just helping them level up their videos.
Cool. So you mentioned, I suppose, LinkedIn kind of, that seems to be your personal preferred platform, is it?
Yeah, LinkedIn is interesting because it has been my preferred platform for the whole time since really starting to create content in August. So I started on Instagram and Snapchat specifically in April of 2018, and then hopped over to LinkedIn in August. So a few months there. Right now I'm targeting more like high level personal brands, and Instagram is actually the way to go for me right now. Okay. It's just easier to get connected to high level entrepreneurs, I think, on Instagram than LinkedIn. And I think it's much easier to sell on LinkedIn actually than LinkedIn, because a lot of people already have their messages, like DMs, flooded with sale bots and automated salespeople, because that's obviously where most of the business connections are. So from a inbound standpoint and like organic content standpoint, I do still like LinkedIn because the reach is still there, more so than Instagram. But as far as like outreach and making those connections, Instagram is the way to go for me.
That's interesting. So you're using Instagram as almost the cold call, would we call it? That's very interesting.
Just all through DMs, all through messages. So it's working really well. And it's something I haven't really tested before until about like a month and a half, 2 months ago. So yeah, just doing cold DM outreach and getting solid results.
Excellent. That's great to hear.
Did you think about when you were switching? Not, you haven't exactly switched. You're not off LinkedIn or anything. That's not what I mean. But when you're kind of making that transition into taking a new platform into consideration, were you thinking of like repurposing your video content again, or were you thinking of starting fresh? Or how are you kind of approaching your Instagram feed even now for those people who you are DMing coming through and looking at your profile?
Yeah, that's a great question. I repurpose a lot of my content. Almost all of it stems from other podcasts or interviews or any stuff like that. So obviously like the format is a little different from like an editing standpoint, but that's just kind of the nitty gritty of it. But as far as the main messaging, it stays pretty consistent throughout LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, podcast. All of it is roughly the same content, just packaged a little differently.
Cool. Just jumping back to LinkedIn, how are you finding in terms, let's say the LinkedIn algorithm, is there things in your videos you're doing that you find get you more reach? Or particular types of videos that seem to get more reach, like whether it be explainers or how-tos or different types of videos like that?
Yeah, I'm awful on the strategy side of things, which is funny because I help people with strategy. I don't like to like put myself in a box. So like, I love testing new things and seeing what works, seeing what doesn't. But it really comes down to, as cliche as it sounds, like the value other people can find in that video and how authentic you're being. So I know both of those, like value and authenticity, is kind of a buzzword, but it's like, that's not a bad thing. They're both solid meanings of words. So it doesn't really matter how you edit the videos. To a certain point, it does. Like a non-edited video at all versus a pretty one with captions and headlines. The captions and headlines will attract more people. It'll get more attention. But if your messaging sucks in the nicely edited video, it's not going to do well. Same thing with the raw video. If the messaging is solid and the point is solid and people really find value of it, that is going to perform better than any of the video without the substance to it. So really make sure that messaging is there, and lean into what makes you unique. We see a lot of videos, millions of videos a day. So there's no way you're going to talk about a new thing. Almost all topics are taken already, but you can relate those topics, any topic in the world, to your personal experience. And that's what makes you unique. So that's why people would watch. So I would definitely say, have a strong message, but then also lean into what makes you unique. That's what really stands out.
Cool. It's easier said than done.
Absolutely. It's hard. It's weird. It's awkward, but it takes practice like anything else.
So for somebody out there who's like, they know the power of video, they know either for their personal brand or their own business, they've got to start making video. In terms of, I suppose there's two aspects to it. One is the equipment side, but I think for most people, you know, pick up your phone. That's probably going to be the best place to start.
100%.
But if you're a small business out there and you want to kick off, any tips for people in terms of either the equipment side, but also in the content creation side, and how to how to kick off their video creation journey, I guess.
Yes, I think the state of the world has provided a lot of opportunities and a lot of eye-opening realizations for a lot of people and companies and brands out there to see how easy it is to make video content. So hop on a Zoom, I would say to start, hop on a Zoom call. This is not a sponsored message for Zoom. I wish it was. Zoom, pay me. but hop on a call with other owners, founders, employees, customers, clients, really anyone you want to talk to and have a conversation, record it, and then rip that those videos into micro content. So as far as the messaging, you want to be authentic with video. You want to add value, like I said, but you don't want it to seem too forced. And I feel like the number one like issue people run into when first starting to create, myself included, is the videos seem so forced and so awkward that no one really watches it because you don't really know how to talk. But anyone knows how to have a conversation for the most part. So just have conversations. And in those conversations, that's why I love podcasts, because they're just conversations and they're just drops of nuggets everywhere. So I would say the easiest way to start, go on Zoom, record that, and then rip that into micro content. Figure out how to do it. Go on YouTube, look it up, do it for free. Super easy. It's free. And I think that's the easiest way to start.
Yeah, we actually did that with a client recently. They're in the furniture business, and we've got the owner of the business and like the sales manager to sit down and have a discussion about all the trends that are happening right now, all the different, you know, types of products coming in, all that kind of stuff. Absolutely fantastic discussion with like loads of fantastic information for people who are looking for furniture, which is obviously their target market. But it's something that, you know, something people don't seem to think of automatically, to actually sit down and just record a discussion in the business. And that is by far and away the number one easiest way to start generating content.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Sorry, when I was editing that as well, I mean, they sat down for what, 30 minutes, and I think I managed to get like at least 5 solid 2 to 3 minute clips from it. Yeah. So you get a lot more than you're going to think from it as well.
100%. And it's not just limited to high level entrepreneurs or big personal brands. Like everyone is doing it. Like we just closed a pharmaceutical laboratory for the same thing. They reached out and say, hey, we have a bunch of Zoom meetings. Can we create micro content from it? I'm like, sure. I've never worked with a scientific laboratory before, but let's do it. So it's cool seeing more businesses, brands, and people opening up to how you communicate online, which is awesome.
Definitely. And it really builds the personal relationship, I think, between the brand and the customer as well, which is obviously extremely key in any sales process.
100%.
So Sam, I don't know if you have any experience with this, but we'll say if somebody's decided then they've kind of on their journey, they started doing that, they're seeing the great results from video and they decide they want to take it up a level. Any kind of key recommendations you would have for people who are kind of bringing video in-house or either hiring someone like yourself or an agency to do it for them?
I guess, could you repeat your question once more?
So if somebody, they know the power of video, they've started off doing their own content, but they want to take it up a level. So they're going to either do it in-house or they're either going to hire an agency. Any recommendations for businesses who are going through that decision-making process?
Yeah, so there's pros and cons to both, like always. In-house is going to cost you more, but you'll have more freedom and flexibility, I think. It depends on who you work with, obviously. Or you can hire an agency. There's a bunch of services out there that does it for you as well. But yeah, I would categorize it as 3 different parts. In-house, definitely the most expensive, but probably have the most freedom, and just flexibility, and you can actually build the relationship. There's the agency side of things, which typically can cost less than hiring in-house just because they have a lot of clients, so they don't need to charge top-end premium, obviously 100% dependent on the agency. You can probably make more content going agency route. So that's a plus, but again, obviously probably a little less flexible. And then there's like the service route. So there's a bunch of services out there. That's the that's probably the cheapest option, but you don't have that actual relationship aspect typically. So if you're super big on building your team and like sharing your values with your team and really building like the brand side of things, services probably aren't the best option for you. But if you're just looking for pure video editing, cheapest, quickest option, it's probably finding a service out there.
Any particular services you'd recommend?
Myself. No, there's a company called Video Husky out there, and that's a company I've been linked up with for a while here. So I've used them in the past. Great people. There's also a company called, I think, Veed.io, V-E-E-D.io.
We use those. You do? Yeah.
I've actually never used it, but I've heard nothing but great things about them. But yeah, just look up video editing software online, and there's a bunch of pretty simple options you can use.
Brilliant. Sam, if anyone's listening, they'd like to find out a bit more about your business and your services, where's the best place for them to head to?
I'm on all social medias at Sam Lister. You can just look up Sam Lister really on LinkedIn, Instagram, TikTok are my main three. I have a podcast called Starting Blank. Really just any of those of the main platforms that you can communicate with me whenever. Instagram DMs are probably the easiest way to communicate right now though.
Cool. Sam, thanks very much for joining us.
Yeah. Thank you so much for having me.
Cheers.
It was an awesome conversation.
Bye-bye.